Welcome to this installment of the Cybersecurity Speaker Series, presented by NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. The mission of the center is to augment and amplify NSA's ability to prevent and eradicate threats to national security systems and the defense industrial base by establishing open, robust, and collaborative relationships across industry and government. Through bidirectional threat intelligence sharing and joint analytic tradecraft development, these partnerships leverage unique talents and capabilities to enhance cybersecurity across the nation.
Welcome to the Speaker Series from NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. My name is Josiah Dykstra, and I'm a technical fellow here at NSA. In the Speaker Series, we invite NSA experts to come share their insights, their expertise, and their experience in cybersecurity. Our topic for today is the Defense Industrial Base, and our guest is Kristina Walter, the Chief of DIB Cybersecurity. Kristina, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
For the sake of the conversation today, can we shorten the phrase Defense Industrial Base to DIB?
Please.
Great. So tell us, Kristina, what is the DIB?
That's a great question. And I think when most people think of DIB or hear DIB, they think of those really big defense contractors that are building the aircrafts or the fighter jets. But really, the DIB is hundreds of thousands of companies. And a majority of them have less than 100 employees and are characterized as small. But they're critical to the manufacturing capability development that supports the warfighter and the Department of Defense. And they're critical to the DoD supply chains.
That's a helpful context. What then is NSA's role in the defense of the DIB?
That's a great question. So NSA has a vast experience looking at nation-state actors targeting critical technologies. And the Defense Industrial Base is a prime target for adversaries to target DoD information on their networks and steal it for their own benefit of military advantage, of building capabilities quicker than we have, of stealing intellectual property. And it's really dangerous to our military advantage as well as economically. They can forego years of research and development to get ahead of us technologically by stealing information that's on unclassified networks in most cases, but critical to the department.
Okay, that sounds like a really big problem, probably one that a whole bunch of the US government plays a role in. What is your specific part of DIB defense?
Sure. In the Collaboration Center, we are really focused on partnerships. So we want to work together with our industry partners to really understand what's happening and help mitigate it. So we really have three lines of effort. The first is focused on bidirectional sharing of information. So we have great insights into nation-state actors, what they might be intending to target. And then we don't have a lot of visibility into the US or networks that our defense industrial base companies own and operate because they're theirs. And so when they can come in and tell us, this is what's happening on my network, here's concerns I have, and if we can work together in spaces like this right here, sitting side by side and understanding the threat, we can understand more rapidly what's happening and address it. Secondarily, we want to develop, tailor, and amplify mitigation guidance to the DIB, things that are specific to defense industrial base cybersecurity, which might be different than other sectors. We want to make sure that's getting out to DIB companies. We post cybersecurity advisories on nsa.gov/cybersecurity to ensure that that information is actionable and is shared timely. And finally, we want to help companies directly. We want to provide them direct cybersecurity assistance. So we've worked with DoD CIO to really expand our capabilities as far as information sharing goes. But more broadly, how do we provide high-impact, low-cost solutions directly to companies that don't have the resources or their cybersecurity expertise to implement those themselves?
That's great. That's a really good mission, one that is critically important for NSA and the government. Let's talk about one of those services specifically. In the first speaker series, we talked about Protective DNS, Protective Domain Name System. How is that project going? Can you give us any update on that?
Absolutely. So that project is going very well. So we Protective DNS, if you're not familiar with it, DNS is essentially the phone book of the internet. It's how somebody can route from a domain name to an IP address, and it can be really designed for usability, but it can be frequently hijacked or used for maliciously to reroute traffic to malicious sites, to exfil critical DoD information, or to control malware that's delivered to a company's network. And so what Protective DNS does, or PDNS, is it leverages a threat feed to block known malicious or suspected malicious sites. So we ran a pilot with about 30 companies. We found in 6 months over 16 million suspicious or malicious domains were blocked by the service. So from a technology perspective, we knew it was really beneficial, and our next step is to really scale that out. So we worked with DOD to get support to scale it out to thousands of companies, really with a focus on those that have DOD contracts and have access to controlled DOD information to protect that information from being exfilled.
So if somebody falls into that category of being eligible, how do they sign up?
Absolutely. So they can visit cybercenter.nsa.gov for more information or email dib_defense@cyber.nsa.gov, and we'll understand if they're eligible and we can enroll them in the service.
That's great. Is there anything else that the Collaboration Center is doing to help protect the DIB?
Absolutely. We're really focusing in this next year on hardening defenses at scale. So we offer, in addition to PDNS, some other services, including vulnerability scanning, which is designed to identify what assets a company has that are public facing, where there might be vulnerabilities, and then leveraging what we know about actors targeting those vulnerabilities to help a company prioritize and mitigate them to address those threats. Second, we're also partnering with technology and cybersecurity providers to the DIB. We found that when we can share information with an internet service provider or a cloud provider, for example, on a malicious state actor who's intending to target their customers, they want to take action to protect their customers, which benefits the DIB at large. So they can really defend at scale.
That's terrific. If there was a member of the DIB watching this today, what would be one thing you would want to, a message you'd want to share with them?
I think the biggest thing is that these nation state actors are sophisticated and persistent. And so it's a multifaceted approach that's required to address them. So I would encourage collaboration. I would encourage them to take advantage of all of the DOD resources that are available to them through DOD CIO as well as NSA. And I would encourage them to participate in the collaborative forums so that they're getting actionable intelligence and we can help defend both public and private networks together.
Well, Kristina, thank you for these really important insights into DIB cybersecurity, and congratulations to your team for making great progress so far.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Please stay tuned to NSA's Twitter account, @NSA Cyber, for the announcement of future talks. See you next time.